What we're gonna do today is we're hopefully gonna build something to make sure that we can keep this nice and tidy.
What do you mean? They don't fit? How come they don't fit?
Well, hello there, and welcome back to our backyard, and more in particular to our swimming pool. I'm just about to open it up because every evening we close our pool. We noticed a couple of advantages. One of them, we've got some serious trees here that tend to shed quite a lot of leaves in the water. The tarp makes sure that our pool stays nice and clean and we don't need quite as many chemicals or clean it out quite as much as we would otherwise have to.
So is that just a rope or elastic?
That's elasticated. Mainly because, as you can see, if the wind plays underneath it, it has a bit of give. Just make sure it doesn't rip easily or it doesn't cause any problems. The other big advantage is the heat. When we close this thing off, combined with what I'll say in just a moment, we've noticed that we barely lose any temperature at all overnight, which is great. This is basically how most people leave their pool overnight, just with a solar cover over it. And it works great, it heats up the pool. In fact, it heats up the pool really well, especially if you combine it with what we did in one of our previous videos. We put these XPS insulation plates underneath, and that really made a massive difference. At the moment, overnight here in Belgium, it still gets quite cool. As in, you know, 13 centigrade, 14 centigrade, something
even
like that.
Even down to 10.
Apparently even down to 10 centigrade. However, our pool has been consistently heating up. And if we close it down with like 27 degrees the next morning, it's still at like 25, 26. We hardly lose any temperature overnight, which is great. Last year, we didn't have those plates underneath yet. And then overnight, we would easily lose 4 centigrade quite quickly, sometimes even more overnight. Whereas now, 2 or even less, depending on how cold it gets overnight. So it makes a big difference. It really does. Back to the tarp that we used to close off the pool overnight. As you can see, it's kind of messy now. What we're gonna do today is we're hopefully gonna build something to make sure that we can keep this nice and tidy. I'm gonna start cutting up some pipes and we're gonna make basically a sort of bracket system to keep the tarp and the solar cover in when we're using the pool. Very simply, what you need is some of this, a bit of PVC piping. You can get it in white as well, but we went with grey just because it matches the pool.
And it was cheaper.
Then the only other thing you need is a bunch of these, some stopcaps, and some glue. I'm gonna start cutting some pipe.
This does not look safe.
It's safe.
What if you slip through and you cut your leg? Oh, people, please don't do what we do. Congratulations, this is why I would have made a mark. Oh, you're still gonna cut your balls off.
Well, the other part is fine, isn't it?
Yeah, okay, but... Oh my goodness. You're special, aren't you?
Yeah, yes I am.
Yeah, that's still an angle. We do the job. We don't ever say we do the job well.
Well, at least we tried.
And while Niels works on the cover holder, I'm gonna make sure that the area around our pool gets a bit prettier. Last year was kind of just a mess with the ground sheet, and this year we've put planters around it and we tidied up the ground sheet. I'm just gonna add a few more flowers to the flower pots. We have some lavender, we have some poinsettias, which were from Christmas, but I still managed to keep alive, so we're planting them outside. Then we've got some pink and purple geraniums, because they're pretty. The lavender mainly, we're hoping will keep like mosquitoes away from the pool. Let's hope anyway. Neil says geraniums stink, and honestly, I don't think they smell of much.
Honestly, the small ones, which is just part of that family of plants, doesn't smell as much.
Yeah, I think that's
but the big ones, the geraniums, they just really smell.
Can you get the hose out?
I'll get my hose out.
And that's looking quite pretty, if I say so myself.
Ended up cutting a whole bunch of these.
We're gonna do 5 brackets, so we need 10.
Yeah, no, we don't, do we?
What?
We need one going down, we need one over there, but we also need something in between, don't we?
You better go buy another pipe.
Pollocks!
And while we're busy prettifying our pool area, let's go see if I can find something else to make it sparkle. This is our junkyard. And there's what I need. Okay. Let's hope these two work.
We went back to the plan. I did buy enough pipe. I didn't have to go back to the shop because in between we don't actually fit the big 40 centimeters long piece. We fit a smaller 30 centimeter small piece. And you basically just end up with a U-shape like this. The idea is that part of this gets attached to one of the poles that holds the pool up, and all the tarp and the solar cover and such will just rest in here. We'll have 5 of those around the edge of the pool, and that will hopefully make everything look a little bit tidier when it's opened up, and also it won't damage the grass underneath, because that's kind of what it's doing in a moment.
What do you mean? They don't fit? How come they don't fit?
How come they don't fit? Well, it says 40 mil pipe on here. That's 40 mil. It'll be fine.
Okay.
Obviously, at the moment, this still moves about, because guess what I'm going to do right now? Glue. That can't possibly go wrong, me and glue. So I'm going to glue these things together, and then it's going on the pool.
You're reading the instructions.
I am.
Are you going to follow the instructions?
I'm mainly going to follow the instructions. Wow, this glue stinks.
And then I got high.
The builders 2 houses down would happily use this indoors. I've seen them use some equipment earlier this week, and I'd just say it was hilarious.
You just put your cleanest side on the inside and the scrappy side on the outside.
Oh, well. Wow. Yeah, that glue works really quickly. Just one more.
You're gonna go back over there and do some other stuff. Come nightfall, we should have some pretty lights going on.
That glue was very strong, very smelly, but also very fast drying. We're not gonna attach it to the pool until tomorrow. In theory, according to the instructions, you're not supposed to use it for 24 hours, but that's because you can send pressured water through these pipes. I'm not sending anything through the pipes, I just wanted to hold a bit of tarp up. So I'm sure it'll be fine with slightly less than 24 hours, but in theory, 24 hours.
Early the next morning.
These are the brackets we made. They've been drying overnight, so the glue should be nice and dry now. And I mean, they look very sturdy. I don't think that's gonna go anywhere. We've attached these things to the pool using some zip ties. If this doesn't fold enough, because it does slide down a little bit, but it seems to stop, so I'm kind of hoping it will be fine. But if it isn't, we'll replace these with those metal things you can get, and then just, you know, use a screwdriver to just get the pressure even higher. I don't want to try it straight away, because the idea of having some sharp metal bits around the liner of the pool is kind of scary. Oh, and when not in use, you can easily just slide these things to the side so you don't really see them.
Will they ever not be in use?
When the cover is on, might as well just get these out of the way so you don't have all these things sticking out.
I guess.
And easier when I go across with the lawnmower.
Oh yeah, good point.
Hey, clever.
Okay, so far so good.
That's actually quite tidy.
Yeah, that's nice.
I quite like that. Notice how we didn't put the end caps on yet, because I bought the wrong size.
And there's room for the solar cover.
Plenty.
Yeah, I like it. Good job.
The bees are liking our new flowers.
And while we're talking cheap gadgets for your pool that you might not think of, here's this little flower pot thingy that you can put on a balcony, and we just put it there. And then when we get into the pool, we just put our glasses in there, put the phone in there, put a drink in there. It's like €3 or something from Action Shop. The Belgians and the Dutch people know what we're talking about. Practical.
Well, yesterday when we closed up the pool, the temperature of the pool was about 25 centigrades. During the night, the ambient temperature has dropped to 10 centigrade, but the pool is still a whopping 24. So we lost 1 degree overnight, which, once again, those insulation plates, get them. They make such a difference.
Oh, and in the background there, we have another project coming up in a few weeks.
Stay tuned. Tam, tam, tam!
Time to add an important wall sign to our pool.